Now, the News 8 Storm Team forecast with meteorologist Joe Calhoun.
Well, nothing happening this morning. It is quiet on the radar scope, but as you pull on out, you can see the southeast getting hammered. Ice and snow. Atlanta could have several inches of snow over to Raleigh-Durham. Another batch of snow in the Midwest. So a lot of travel headaches today, but not here in the Northeast for us. For us, some sunshine. And it looks like we will have a brisk wind, but not as gusty as yesterday. Cold one. You know, we'll only get to near freezing today. Just some high-level clouds coming in. It'll cloud over tonight. Cold night, though, before the clouds get here. I think we're in the teens to around 20 degrees. Then probably only in the 20s to maybe near 30 tomorrow with snow arriving later in the afternoon. I'll time it out for you here in just a second. It could be affecting tomorrow evening commute, but most of the snow is coming tomorrow night. Right now we're 23. Wind chill of 10 because winds are still northwest at around 15. They were up around 20, 30, 40 miles an hour yesterday, so they've settled down some. But, you know, all in all, it's a cold morning. Temperatures teens. Look at Sealands Grove down to 9 degrees, but not much wind there. Most of the wind chills in the low teens to single digits this morning. Looking live over Harrisburg, all is quiet right now. We can see the flag flapping around by the Capitol, though. A little bit on the gusty side. It's all because of that storm that came through here on Saturday with a little light snow. You can still see the northwesterly flow. There's the storm spinning out to sea, but high pressure is now building in. Look at all that precipitation to the south. And you say, wow, it's right on our doorstep. But high pressure and that northerly flow behind that storm going to keep it at bay for now. But that Midwestern storm is going to start to move eastbound, and that's going to help this to start to move in. That northerly flow moves out of the way. High pressure moves out of the way. So there goes the storm. The energy from this, which will give us, I think, some more widespread snow with this, because it's not just a coastal storm. There's one storm inland, one storm on the coast. This will become the main storm, but I think we'll at least get a couple of inches because of this crossing the area. But then the energy transfers off the coast. That's the heaviest tomorrow night. Then starts winding down, and we get gusty winds behind it as we go into Wednesday. Look at the predictor snowfall amounts for the southeast. You're talking 7, 8, 9 inches of snow down south. Those folks aren't used to that. Most of our snow, though, comes tomorrow night. And we're looking at a couple of inches around here, 2 to 4. I think it's a plowable snow. Heavier as you get over toward Chester County and maybe even Berks in the Lehigh Valley and Philadelphia area, 4 to 8. Could even see up to a foot in parts of Jersey and up toward New York City. Not as heavy as the after Christmas storm for the eastern sections, but more for us, more widespread. And again, this is that plowable kind of snow. So here's the timetable. Late tomorrow evening, the snow starts to arrive. I think it's a little quicker than the predictor was showing us, but it's here by, I think, the evening rush hour. Heavy is coming tomorrow night, and then it's over with as we go into Wednesday morning. Beyond that, though, it's just cold out there. Windy, gusty end to the week with temperatures not much better than that freezing point. So, yeah, it's going to stay on the cold side.
Yeah, so it means the snow will stick around.
Stick it around for a couple of days, yeah, at least.
All right, thanks a lot, Joe.